Alright, what's up everybody? So today, got another video for you guys, and what we're going to be working on is a frog. So here's the reference picture on the left, and here's the lines that I used for the stencil on the right. So, hola amigos, bienvenidos. Aquí está la foto que vamos a estar usando hoy. Es una foto de una rana. Aquí en la izquierda y luego a la derecha están las líneas que usé para hacer la plantilla de la rana. Y esto va a ser lo que vamos a estar haciendo hoy. Y sí, so voy a hacer esta foto un poco más pequeña y para un lado. Para que nomás para que se recuerden. Aquí tenemos la plantilla, so here we have our stencil that I've cut out, and obviously the back is one piece, so la parte de atrás, la parte de abajo, y luego el palo, so we have the stick part, and then we have this little piece that's part of the stick, right? And then we have our frog, and then I've cut out the mouth here. Cut out this arm, so he cortado la boca aquí, esta mano está recortada hasta acá, también esta mano, y luego lo que he hecho aquí es los pies, está cortado y así, so this foot is cut this way and that way, and it's made so that we could fold it over just like that, it's held together right there, so ahí en esa parte de ahí es donde se detiene, pero está hecho para doblar, so it's made so it can fold, right? Same thing on this side, we have it cut both ways, and then we have it made so it can fold over like this. So it's all just held in right there. It's made out of stencil plastic, so it's really strong, resilient, it's not going to rip on you or nothing like that. If you use paper, you know, it's probably going to rip. And actually, I wasn't done cutting this one. Started, so get to watch me cut the eyes out. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut. So se me olvidó cortar los ojos. Aquí vamos a cortar estas partes en tres. So I'm just gonna cut these parts in three. Right, there's one eye. This stencil paper is really thick, and the stencil plastic, so even cutting it with a blade doesn't give you problems, but that's what you want, because you want it to last you, right? You want to be able to use it again later on. That's what these stencils are for. It's ultra tough, thin plastic, very, very tough stuff. Make sure not to lose any of your pieces, so. Si están usando plástico para plantillas, es muy durable, muy resistente a quebrarse o a romper, y también a cortarlo, so hay que ponerle bastante presión cuando lo estás cortando, y usar una navaja muy, muy fuerte. Cut that out. Take that out of there. There we go. Cool. So again, there's all our pieces. Our frog piece, how it's cut out. Así está todo recortado. Y el palo y todo. So voy a poner pegamento sobre nuestras plantillas. Y luego luego voy a seguir y les voy a enseñar cómo usar esta plantilla para hacer el dibujo. So, I'm just going to switch you guys' cameras real quick. And then I'm going to go put some 3M on this. And then I'll be back and I'll show you guys how to use the stencil to make what we're going to make today. So let me just go get some glue real quick. Paper. So I'm gonna start sticking my stuff on. So voy a poner nuestros plantillas, empezando con la más grande. Luego nuestra rana. So start with the biggest part. Lay in the frog. Get them there nice and straight. And then we're gonna put our log piece in. Nuestra parte de madera, igual que siempre, asegúrense que todo esté de derechito. So just make sure everything's nice and straight. Slide it around if you need to. Little pieces never seem to get enough glue on them. So you want to re-glue that. And what else? The eye. I'm gonna leave that like that because we're gonna just spray black on that. The sides. Really quick to put the black. So, voy a usar estos muy de volada para poner el negro de los ojos. So, I'm gonna have some stuff. Keep this like this. Yeah, that looks good. So, voy a poner el negro de los ojos rápidamente. Little bit of tape.
quickly. Un poco de negro rápidamente. Can you give me a napkin or two? Okay, so we can take the eyes off. Podemos quitar nuestros ojos. Thank you. And then we're gonna do a little bit of black around the edge. So, vamos a usar un poco de negro sobre la orilla de los ojos. Y nomás tantito, tantito. So, just slightly, and we'll shade that in around. Smallest edge ever. Now we're going to switch to some red. Voy a cambiar al rojo. This is just Createx Bright Red. Ojos con rojo y luego vamos a cambiar a café. So we're going to switch to some brown and we're going to work on our little stick that he's sitting on. And we're going to try to get that stick in there nice. Just a little Createx light brown. I'm going to take this, get it off, just stick to the side. Now we're going to go ahead and, using the reference picture, right, go back and look at it. And, you know, just start laying it in there. And it's okay if you go over your stencil. Coloreando el palo donde está una ranita sentada aquí y agregándole líneas de bronce a textura a este palo. Bueno, es un café ligero y luego voy a cambiar un poco de gris. So I'm gonna switch to gray. Work the wood in a little bit using the gray. So, agregando un poco de detalle a la madera usando el gris. El gris y el café te da una manera medio suave. Y luego le vamos a dar una sombra a la agua. So, we're going to give a little shadow to our frog friend here. Go ahead and drop in a shadow along the edge, the bottom edge of the frog stencil. Same thing on this side. And right up in here. Very quickly, we're going to switch over to some black. And then we're just going to really close to some of these crepes, like right in between the fingers right here. So, cambiando al negro. Y solamente en estas áreas aquí, como entre los dedos y aquí donde se profundo. Más ligeramente un poco de negro. We're just going to get in there nice and lightly. Black. You don't want to overdo it, just right in some of those spots. You already have gray, so so you don't need to go too crazy. That's it, we're pretty much done with the wood. Go ahead and put that back on there. And then we're going to start working on our frog friend here. So ya podemos tapar nuestra madera aquí. Y vamos a empezar a trabajar sobre la rana. So we're going to switch to gray. So vamos a cambiar a gris. Start with this leg right here. Luego vamos a empezar con esta pierna de la izquierda aquí. And we're gonna fold, kind of take that over, like so. So vamos a mover esta parte así. Y luego, bueno, usamos la referencia. Vamos a ver el sombrado. And then using the reference picture, just shade it in. Shadow like this, and then we can go ahead and lift this whole thing up and fold it over. Podemos levantar todo, y hacerle un lado, darle un poco de sombreado aquí, y luego usando la referencia de la foto, aquí tenemos una sombra aquí y aquí abajo de los dedos. Okay, so just kind of use your reference photo, give us a little bit of shadow for the fingers and stuff. And then we're going to move over to this side, the right leg. And peel this off. Okay. And you want to just peel off the top part again. And go back to our reference. Right here where we fold it over, and use your reference to add any dark spots to see. Put that in, and we can put our stencil back. So, ya teniendo eso, podemos poner esta parte un poco más. Y ahora vamos a quitar esta mano de aquí. So, now we're going to take off the right hand. Actually, no. We're going to leave the hand, we're going to take off the belt. So vamos a quitar esta parte del estómago primero. Ah, y esto lo podemos levantar, lo podemos doblar. And we're gonna give it an edge. It's this whole bottom edge right here. And give it a light shadow. So una sombreada aquí en las manos de la rana. Y vamos a doblar este para adentro. So we're gonna fold this in like this. Is lift this right leg right here. So I'm going to levantar aquí. No, the left leg. It's mine. I'm confused. So esta parte de la izquierda, esta mano, la vamos a levantar. Ahora esto podemos levantarlo. Y le vamos a dar un poco de sombreado. So we're just going to have a little bit of shading right where it goes up against the other arm. For the wood, but that's okay. And then we're gonna peel all this back all the way to the mouth, and then we're just gonna give it a really light shade across the lips. So vamos a levantar todo esto, nomás una línea lo mejor fina que puedan sobre el labio aquí. Y se me hace que ya podemos quitar la luna. Once you're done with all that, you take off your frog stencil here. Make sure your wood's nice and line. And I need to find my piece that went flying. Get that in there. Now we're gonna start throwing this in.
some little bit of texture. Still using the gray. Obviously, the stomach on the frog is the texture. So we're just gonna go ahead and do some dots as best as you can here. So we're gonna lick on unos puntos, pues, para darle la textura a la rana sobre el estómago. Y aquí, usando la referencia, podemos ver dónde necesita textura. Además, le puede dar puntos muy, muy, muy ligeros, right? So I'm just using these really nice fine dots to create texture here. They don't all have to be super detailed, you know. Some of them could be fuzzy, some could be really sharp. It's okay. So then we're gonna go ahead and start texturizing some of this other area, right? So these are not just flat like this. It kind of has like some webbing here, so we're gonna do some of that. And then he has this little kind of like a slimy texture going on. So just using a little bit of lines to find our fingers and a little bit of really fine strokes. Get in there and get nice and sharp. Maybe do something like this in there and then shade it. Yeah. So, usando un poco de líneas, le estamos dando la textura de la rana, estas áreas más ligeramente, no tienen que hacer líneas muy super finas. Lo mejor que la hagan, lo mejor que les va a salir, lo mejor que les va a salir el dibujo. Y nomás usando la referencia aquí, hagan las líneas que pueden ver. So just use your reference picture wherever you have doubts, and it's always good to draw what you see. So if you see it in the picture, don't be afraid to try to put it in there. This frog has kind of like a throat going on here. Shade that in right here. Just work nice and light. Don't try to get ahead of yourself. The shadows away from where you want to get in there. Right here is where you have to kind of like your jaw. No trabajen ligeramente. Métanse ahí suavemente donde puedan. Y vean la textura usando el gris. Texture wherever you see. Alright, so here we're going to switch off to some green, and I'm going to use fluorescent green to create texture. This is just what I'm going to start off with. So estoy usando verde fluorescente de Createx. Es un verde muy, muy, muy alto. Y este es el verde que vamos a darle la primera pasada de color, pues. So, I'm gonna start off right here on this one. You wanna be pretty precise with what you're painting. You don't wanna just fling the paint everywhere, you know? Get in there and color it, and make sure you're using, I think that the fluorescent paint is already kind of transparent, so you don't have to worry about it going over your gray or completely messing up your picture. You can kind of see, you can see the gray still through it, and it just accents it more than anything. Okay, we're going to fill in this back leg right here. It has
On this side, we got a little bit of green on this finger, and then around his knee right here. So nomás use la referencia, y si miran un poco de verde en su referencia, aquí es usar la referencia, la foto que tenemos aquí, que estamos usando. Nomás trabajen ligeramente y muy cerca de su plantilla. Este es un proyecto un poco más avanzado, pero de todos modos, si están aprendiendo, esto es algo que pueden hacer para que se pongan mejor. Switch to what's Maui Blue from CreateX, and it's kind of like a sky blue, but it matches what we're doing on our frog pretty good, and that's why we're using it. So voy a estar usando un color que se llama Maui Blue, so Maui Azul, Azul de Maui, y es un color más o menos azul cielo, y este da muy bueno con nuestra rana, por eso lo estoy usando hoy. Just give me one sec. Trying to get some of this. Just trying to get some Maui blue in this model. So you could also use another kind of blue if you want, but this Maui blue kind of matches the frog perfectly. Get some from the big bottle because this one's out. Okay, so I got some blue in here, and we're just gonna use our reference picture again. We have some blue right here. Just like that. So I'm going this way. Right here. So nomás usen esa referencia. Darle el azul donde va. Nomás rellenen sus áreas apropiadamente, ligeramente, no es una carrera. ¿Ya? Y si son rápidos, si algo les sale así, pueden limpiarlo rápidamente con su mano. Si nomás tengan cuidado y ligeramente coloreen la rama. if you're fast, if you get a little bit of splatter like that, you can catch it. Just wipe it away real quick with your finger. Just use your reference picture and fill it in. There you go, and then we're gonna switch to some orange. So much color searching today, but it's worth it for something like what we're doing today. It's gonna make a pretty cool picture. And it requires very minimal black, has a lot of color. Stuff. I'm missing my unclogging needle. Is there not enough orange? Well, seems pretty empty. Let me grab some orange. All my bottles are running low. Orange in here. Alright, so we're just gonna start filling these areas where the orange meets the other colors. I think the orange is the coolest part of this frog. We don't see orange on too many animals in the wild, tigers and stuff. Rare you see like this really bright orange. Fill it in. You just want to be a little bit careful. You could even use the stencil, put it back on. You feel a little more comfortable that way. Just coloring it in. Wherever you see. You need some. A little bit on the eyes there. Foot over here. So, someone can put another hollow. Vamos coloreando nuestras alas aquí. So, we're just filling this in. Nice and light. Make sure you get the orange nice and bright. Alright. Then we're going to switch over to some white. So, vamos a cambiar un poco de blanco. So using the white, we're just gonna add some highlights. So anywhere you see it, kind of in the picture, like right here, a little dot, and this little squiggle going up. Bam. Same thing over here. Like that, live wide. Maybe bring some of these lines in. Like this. Add a little bit of dots for texture. So you can both extrude that with Cinza Blanco. Alright, so just wherever you see it in the picture, just add a little white highlights, a little dots. You've been practicing your dots, this is where they come in really handy. Dots and dagger strokes. You know how to make lines and stuff. This is where they come in. So, para los que han practicado sus líneas y sus puntos, esto es aquí donde les va a ayudar. Saber muy bien cómo son los puntos y su línea. Si nomás estamos usando puntos para darle partes altas al dibujo, ¿verdad? Usamos la referencia. Estamos aquí rellenando nuestras partes altas. Y si han practicado sus líneas y sus puntos, aquí les va a ayudar bastante. Sí. Estamos rellenando, dándole detalle. Going back in there, giving it all detail. Get in there. You see it in the picture, you should add it in. Once you're satisfied and you feel okay with it, and you think you've got enough stuff in there, whether it be texture or whatever it is, go ahead and peel it off. So ya cuando estén satisfechos con el trabajo que han hecho, pueden quitar su plantilla. Simplemente. Now, this particular stencil would look really great against the black backdrop, but it looks pretty good even like this. And the camera's probably didn't pick up the fluorescent green very well, but it's really bright, I promise you. There we go. Y ahí tienen su foto de la rana. La cámara no recoge muy bien el verde fluorescente, no sé por qué, pero está bien brillo, o sea, bien alto. No sé por qué se mira medio pasteloso en la cámara, pero está más alto que el anaranjado, pero no sé por qué razón se mira así en la cámara. Pero saludos a todos: Alex, Sandro, Lionel, Yolín, Dan, Sully, todos. ¿Cómo están? So, you know, thank you everybody for watching. If I said your name, I don't know why it's not picking up fluorescent green. That's kind of bugging me actually, because it looks weird in this shade. But it's really bright. If you use a fluorescent green, you'll know what I mean. It looks. I want to see if it does that with this. It does do that with this. It's fluorescent green, but it looks weird. Let's see if it. I'll do it up here. The fluorescent green, do you see that? It looks like a pastel green on that. Even the bottle look. I don't know if it's just my monitor or what. That's how it looks too. Yeah, I don't know. That's just the camera doing that. I don't know why the orange looks really bright, but the green doesn't. Anyway. But yeah, hopefully that helps some of you guys out. You know, I've been trying to keep these videos going. This is number 10. If you want to put your stencil in and spray a black background, that's cool. And actually, what we should do is add a little white highlight to his eye. Para ver una parte subida al ojo para que se mire como que está brillando ahí. Y ahí está. So, ojalá les ayude. Este ya es el video número 10 de estas series de videos que estoy haciendo. Estos videos son completamente gratis, nomás tienen que ver un poco de advertencias o, como se dice, comerciales, pues. All, you know, I'm gonna keep these videos free forever. All you gotta do is sit through some ads. You know, I'm sorry about the ads, but that's how I get paid. If you want to support the stream at any time, there's a link down in the description. You can help me out, you know, send a dollar or two, whatever, it helps. If you don't want to, if you can't or don't have the money, you know, you can share it out on your favorite airbrush group or whatever it is, and help your other fellow airbrushers get better. So, si, you know, quieren ayudar, si no quieren ver comerciales, o si quieren que los comerciales se vayan y ya no tengan que ver comerciales, en la descripción del video hay una manera que ustedes me pueden apoyar. Y sí, cada dólar o cada centavo, you know, me ayuda a traerles más videos. Voy a mantener estos videos gratis para siempre, nomás a ver comerciales. Y si no pueden, si no tienen dinero para ayudar, es muy bueno repartir los videos en sus redes sociales, en sus grupos de Facebook o lo que sea que tengan, y repártanlos con los otros aerografistas para que todos podamos aprender. Y sí, ojalá les ayude, les guste el video, y nos vemos en el video que sigue. Gracias a todos. So, thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you guys in the next video. Later.